Hello students, in the previous lecture we discussed about the storage devices. Now we will be discussing about computer software and hardware. It is very important topic as you should know what are the parts of computer which are considered as software and which one is considered as hardware. So we will be seeing them one by one and we will be starting with computer software. If we talk about computer software, it consists of software itself is a composition of software and hardware. Now we need to understand what exactly a hardware is and what exactly a software is. Computer system का what is a computer system? इसमें combination होता है software and hardware. ठीक है, हम hardware देख रहे हैं. Hardware are those electronic devices that are capable of computing and manipulating information. कंप्यूटर हार्डवेयर क्या है, आपके इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिवाइसेस हैं जो आपके कंप्यूटिंग एंड मैनिपुलेटिंग ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन करते हैं. राइट, नाउ सॉफ्टवेयर क्या है, दीज आर द सेट ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शंस दैट कैरी आउट प्री डिफाइंड टास्क टू कंप्लीट अ जॉब. तो एक सेट ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शंस है जो भी कंप्यूटिंग या मैनिपुलेटिंग करनी है उसके लिए जो सेट ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शंस होते हैं दैट आर कॉल्ड एज सॉफ्टवेयर. सो कंप्यूटर इज अ कंपोजिशन ऑफ सॉफ्टवेयर एंड हार्डवेयर. सॉफ्टवेयर है सेट ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शंस दैट आर गिवन टू परफॉर्म द जॉब एंड हार्डवेयर आर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिवाइसेस विच आर कैपेबल ऑफ डूइंग द इंफॉर्मेशन डूइंग मैनिपुलेटिंग प्रोसेसिंग ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन. अगर सिंपल लैंग्वेज में देखें तो कंप्यूटर सॉफ्टवेयर रेफर्स टू computer program that causes computer to carry out particular operations. So computer software helps the computer program to carry out the operations. If these are the program, software kuch nahi hai, simply program hai. Program means that are written in some kind of language like C, C++, Java, Python. Usme likha hua hai code hai that is giving instruction to the computer to perform particular operations. Theek hai, ab इसमें चलते हैं. कंप्यूटर इटसेल्फ कांट थिंक, कंप्यूटर की अपनी सोचने की समझने की शक्ति नहीं होती है. इट परफॉर्म्स ऑपरेशंस लाइक एडिशन, सब्ट्रैक्शन, मल्टीप्लिकेशन एंड डिवीजन ओनली व्हेन द यूजर और व्हेन यू पीपल आर गिविंग इंस्ट्रक्शन टू द कंप्यूटर टू डू दैट पर्टिकुलर ऑपरेशन. जब तक यूजर इंटरफेरेंस नहीं होगा द कंप्यूटर विल नॉट एबल टू परफॉर्म एनी टास्क. राइट, सो द यूजर इश्यूज द इंस्ट्रक्शंस and the CPU act according with the instructions. As I have already told that CPU releases signals to perform instructions. So the set of instruction which control the sequence of operations means which instruction will be executed first. There will be a set of sequence to perform those instructions. So वो जो instructions का एक combination है that are known as program and the programs are collectively known as software. So instructions set of instructions equals to program and program set of programs equals to software. So program हमारा जो software है हमारा वो कुछ नहीं है, simply एक program है that is written in a code or in a language. एक set of instructions है जो piled up कर दिए गए हैं एक साथ. So the combination of physical equipment या physical devices like hardware and the logical instructions which are used to perform those instructions. तो ये क्या होगा, हमारा फिजिकल इक्विपमेंट प्लस लॉजिकल इंस्ट्रक्शंस इज अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ इज मेकिंग द कंप्यूटर सिस्टम एंड इट गिव्स द मॉडर्न कंप्यूटिंग पावर सिस्टम टू गिव द पावर टू वर्सेलिटी एंड गिव देम अपॉर्चुनिटी टू डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ टास्क. अब इसकी डेफिनेशन देखते हैं. कलेक्शन ऑफ कंप्यूटर डेटा एंड instructions. So what exactly the software is doing, as I have already told that it is a set of instructions or it is a set of program. Set of instructions equals to program, set of programs equals to software. So simply a code hai jo ek kisi particular language mein likha gaya hai and that is helping to perform certain instructions or certain operations. Theek hai, so it is responsible for controlling, integrating and managing. So this is very important, these three terms. It is responsible for controlling, integrating and managing the hardware component of a computer to accomplish a specific task. So kya karte hain hardware ke jitne bhi components hai, making them as a whole aur usko integrate karte hain, control karte hain and they perform a certain task. So ek software kya hai, it tells the computer to what to do and how to do, kya karna hai and kaise karna hai. Right, for example, software instructs the hardware what to display on the user's screen, what kind of input to take from users, and what kinds of output to generate. Kya input lena hai, kya output generate karna hai, and what is to be displayed on that screen. So these are all the software which are doing the these type of tasks. So the software communicates with the hardware by organizing the control sequences, and the hardware carried out the instructions defined by the software. Software define karta hai aur ki kya karna hai, kaise karna hai with the help of hardware. So software, a computer need to be instructed to perform any task. As I have told, computer apne aap kuch nahi karta. We have to give certain instructions to perform the task. So these instructions are given in the form of computer programs. Programs means these are written in certain programming languages. You must have heard about like C, C++, Java, Python. So these are the programming languages in which the codes are written. The program controls the activity of processor. A set of program which are specifically written to provide a user with precise functionality, like solving a specific problem. We are talking about specific problem. Then it is a software package. Right, for example, word processing software package provide functionality to computer so that it can use to create documents like letter and mailing list. Now, what is the relationship between the software and the hardware? Software refers to the computer program that are loaded into the computer system. Kya hai software? Are the computer programs. Software nothing is nothing, simply the computer programs that are loaded into the computer system. And the hardware are all the visible devices that are assembled to build a computer system. Hardware aapko visible hoga, all the devices which are assembled together to build a computer system. Ab kya hota hai, both hardware and software will go simultaneously. Aisa nahi hai that software will work separately and hardware will work separately. Both will be working together. Even though hardware is a physical part of a computer, it is nothing. Hardware is nothing unless there is a software to control it. Agar so hardware hai jo aapko physically dikh raha hai, but nobody is there to control, means software is not there, so it is of no use. In a similar way, if software is there, hardware is not there, then whom to control? Kisko control kiya jayega? So hardware and software both will go together. Now, if what are the categories of software? Two types of categories hai software ki. One is system software and another is application software. So system software are those computer program whose purpose is to help the users. Kya karte hain? Users ki help karte hain to run the computer system. Theek hai, ab hum application ki baat karte hain. Employs capabilities of computer directly to a task that user wishes to perform. Now application wo hai jo user chahta hai ki wo task perform kiya jaye. Theek hai, so system software any program whose purpose is to help the users. Computer system ko run karane ke liye user ki jo help karta hai, that is system software. Application software ki baat karte hain, it employs capabilities that a computer directly to that a user wishes to perform. So jo bhi task user wants to perform, that is application software. See, these are the examples of application and system software. So hum dekhenge yahan pe application software ki baat kare to database management, presentation, spreadsheet, image editors, word processor and desktop publishing software. So these are all application software. These are the examples you have to mention while writing your answers. So agar system software ki baat kare to jaise jo that is helping the computer to run, like operating system. Without operating system your computer will not run. Like device drivers, again, without device drivers your system will not run. System utilities which are required for the system to work on. So without this also, language translator. So all these are system software without which your computer will not work. So if we are talking about application software, means these are the tasks that the user wishes to perform. So these are application softwares, and that this the lower part is your system software. Now we will be looking about the system software in this lecture. In the next lecture, we will be discussing about application softwares. So system software consists of several programs which are directly responsible for controlling, integrating and managing the individual hardware component of a computer system. These three words are very, very important. Responsible for controlling, integrating and managing the individual hardware component. Now, you must have noticed that a computer system is accompanied with some software stored in either a CD or a DVD, which is supplied by the manufacturer. Whenever buy a new computer, what happens is your system is accompanied with set of CDs which you have to install before working before you start working with the computer. So this software manages and supports the computer system and the information processing activities. So system software is more transparent and less noticed by the users as usually interacts with the hardware or the applications. So the system software provides a programming environment in which the programmer can create application to accommodate their needs. So system software is more transparent and less noticed by users as generally it is interacting with the hardware. This environment provides functions that are not able at the hardware level and perform the task related to the execution of application program. So system software, I have given examples like operating systems and device drivers. If your system is not installed with an operating system, how the other functions are going to work on? ठीक है, तो क्या है, सबसे पहले जो बेसिक फंक्शनैलिटीज हैं जो सिस्टम को रन कराने के लिए रिक्वायर्ड है, दैट इज दैट आर नोन एज सिस्टम सॉफ्टवेयर्स. नाउ दिस पिक्चर विल क्लियरली डिफाइन. सी, दिस इज अ कंप्यूटर यूजर, और यू कैन से यू आर हेयर. नाउ यू आर इंटरेक्टिंग विद एप्लीकेशन सॉफ्टवेयर. यू विशेस टू वर्क ऑन सर्टेन स्पेसिफिक टास्क, बट यू वॉन्ट सर्टेन सिस्टम सॉफ्टवेयर टू रन दीज एप्लीकेशन सॉफ्टवेयर. See, if you don't have an operating system, will you be able to work on Microsoft Office? अगर आपके सिस्टम में ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम ही नहीं है, डिवाइस ड्राइवर ही नहीं है, तो आप कैसे काम करोगे प्रेजेंटेशन पे? So, system software is required to perform these application softwares. Now, in simple terms, system software makes the computer functional. It provides basic functionalities like financial management, visual display, keyboard input, and are used by application software to accomplish these functions. So we will see certain examples of system software that are operating systems, device drivers, language translators, and system utilities. So these are certain examples of system software which are helping the application program to run. Now, system software, we will be seeing the operating system first. The first layer of software loaded into the computer memory when it starts up. जैसे ही आपका computer start होता है, the first thing that is to be loaded is the operating system. As the first software layer, all other system software gets loaded after it depends on the various common core services. तो सबसे पहले जो आपका computer में load होगा, that is your operating system. These common core services include disk access, memory management, task scheduling, and user interfacing. Once operating system has installed, so uske baad depending on ki kya kis kis cheez ki need hai, on the basis of that these core services will be like you want to go for disk access or you want to do the memory management, task scheduling, or user interfacing. These tasks will be performed after your operating system has installed in the computer. In addition, the operating system ensured that different programs executing at the same time do not interfere each other. So, क्या होगा इसके अलावा, ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम ये इंश्योर करेगा कि आपके दो काम एक साथ हो, बट दोनों के बीच में कोई इंटरफेरेंस ना हो, बोथ द वर्क विल वर्क पैरेलली. सो इट प्रोवाइड अ सॉफ्टवेयर प्रोग्राम प्लेटफॉर्म ऑन टॉप विच अदर प्रोग्राम्स कैन रन. We see certain examples of operating systems are Windows XP, Unix, Linux. The latest versions are Windows 8 and Windows 10. The Windows 10 is the latest version that is currently in the market. Now, the next system software is the device drivers. Now, the device drivers are system programs which are responsible for proper functioning of devices. ये ऐसे system programs हैं that are responsible for functioning of devices. अब device कैसे सकते हैं? It could be the printer, it could be a monitor, mouse, keyboard, as a driver program associated with it. अगर इनके साथ कोई भी drive, every device has a device program. If the device program is not installed, then how that particular things will work. Whenever a new device is added to the computer, a new device driver has to be installed. कोई भी डिवाइस हम इसमें इंस्टॉल करते हैं, देन देयर हैज टू बी सम डिवाइस ड्राइवर्स आर देयर बिफोर यूजिंग इट. सपोज आपने ब्लूटूथ किया है, ब्लूटूथ को इंस्टॉल करने के लिए देयर विल बी सर्टेन डिवाइस ड्राइवर्स विच आर रिलेटेड टू ब्लूटूथ. सो इफ ब्लूटूथ ड्राइवर्स आर नॉट इंस्टॉल्ड, योर ब्लूटूथ विल नॉट वर्क, यू आर नॉट एबल टू ट्रांसफर योर फाइल्स. तो डिवाइस एक्ट्स एज अ ट्रांसलेटर बिटवीन द डिवाइस एंड द प्रोग्राम. ये क्या करता है, एक ट्रांसलेटर की तरह काम करता है बिटवीन द डिवाइस एंड द प्रोग्राम दैट यूजेस द डिवाइस. जो डिवाइस है और जो प्रोग्राम डिवाइस को यूज कर रहा है उनके बीच में एक इंटरफेस का काम करता है और एक ट्रांसलेटर का काम करता है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल व्हेन अ यूजर वांट्स टू प्रिंट अ डॉक्यूमेंट, द प्रोसेसर इश्यूज, मीन्स द सीयू इज रिलीजिंग द कमांड टू द प्रिंट ड्राइवर एंड द डिवाइडर. जो ड्राइवर है वो क्या करेगा, उस कमांड को ट्रांसलेट करके इनटू स्पेशलाइज्ड इंस्ट्रक्शन so that the printer can understand. Now CU ने instructions release किए हैं printer driver की तरफ, printer driver ने उसको convert कर दिया है specialized instruction में so that the printer is able to understand what to print. A device driver is not an independent program, अपना अलग नहीं है, it assist and is assisted by operating system. Now इसके लिए operating system होने की जरूरत है. Now the next level of system software that we are talking is the language translators. Language translator क्या है, computer only understand machine language. सिर्फ binary language understand करता है, binary means 0 and 1. However, it is difficult for a program to understand the machine language. Now, if we are seeing about the person is not able to understand what it is written in 0 and 1 form. To ease the burden of program, special programming languages like high level languages are developed like C, C++, Java, so that the people is understand, so that the computer is able to understand what it is written. So the computer understand only machine language. A tool is required to translate high level language to machine language and vice versa. We are able to understand high level language, computer is able to understand machine language, so there should be a translator in between to deal with both. So like if we are entering the data into high level language, it needs to be converted into machine language so that the computer is able to understand. Now if something is written in machine language, now we are not able to understand that, so in that case we need some translator to translate the machine language into high level language so that we are able to understand what computer is trying to tell. So with every programming language, a language translator is also developed which accept the program that are written in programming language and performs the translation part. Word translator help in converting the programming language into machine language. The language translators we will learn in another lecture what are the different types of translators. Now the next level of system software are system utility. System utility program perform day-to-day tasks related to the maintenance of software. Every device needs some maintenance too. So these are used to support, enhance and secure existing program and the data in the computer system. So they are generally small programs having specific tasks to perform. Some utility programs are usually provided along with the operating system. Some are free while some need to be purchased as the third party commercial vendors. So system utility means these are used for the maintenance purpose. Now system software, these are the system softwares. The most common system utilities are mentioned here. So file management, backup, data recovery, virus protection, disk management and firewalls. So these we will be discussing in the next lecture. So we will be ending this lecture here only. So what we have discussed today is what is a computer, what is a computer hardware, what is a computer software, what are the different types of software. We have seen the various system softwares too. And the last we were discussing about the system utility. As it will take long time, this lecture is very long. So we will be discussing the system utilities in the next lecture. So thank you.